If you are like most people, password organization is probably one of those things that's been on your to-do list since 2000 and forever. If that's the case, then be sure to stay tuned, because today I'm going to teach you an easy-to-follow workflow that will have all of your passwords organized in no time. This works on both Mac and Windows, and best of all, the only piece of software that you're going to need for this process is one that you probably already own. How to organize your passwords, coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, this video is partially a follow-up to last week's class. In that tutorial, I taught you how to create a digital will by assigning a legacy contact. That way, one day when you pass away, there's a plan for what to do with your digital assets. Most importantly, your photos. Now, one of the topics that came up in that video was that Apple does not give your loved ones access to Keychain data, which contains all of your saved usernames and passwords. In my opinion, I felt like Apple should have at least made it optional whether or not to include that data, because I frequently work with people who have lost loved ones. These people have just gone through a horrible trauma, and now they have to relive that trauma as they go through the horribly painful process of trying to figure out how to get into all of their loved ones' accounts and deal with each of those accounts appropriately. I bring this up because when you're done watching this class, one of the things that you'll end up with is a clean and easy to read document that has a list of all of your usernames and passwords. If you want to make your own death a lot less painful for those you leave behind, I strongly recommend that you give that document to the person that you designate as your digital executor or your lawyer. Two of the most common password-related problems that people encounter are reusing the same passwords, and if you use more than one web browser, you may have discovered that you have different passwords stored in different browsers, which makes it very difficult to remember which one has the most recent data. Another big problem that people encounter is not knowing where to store their passwords. Do you keep it in a web browser, or do you use a dedicated password-saving app like 1Password or LastPass? Now, this may come as a surprise to some of you, but I am not actually going to make a specific recommendation. And the reason why is because the best solution for you should be based on a combination of what devices you own and what web browser you use. So here's how this video works. What I'm going to do is teach you how to extract all of the stored usernames and password data out of all of your different web browsers. Then what we're going to do is merge all of that data together into one central document, specifically a spreadsheet. Why a spreadsheet, you ask? Well, it makes it a lot easier to visualize many of the most common problems that people encounter, including duplicate usernames and passwords, dead accounts, old passwords, and it even presents a perfect opportunity to update all of those reused passwords. I'm speaking specifically to all of you. And then I'm going to teach you a bunch of tricks to help clean up that list. And when all is said and done, we can use that document to replace whatever password data that you currently have stored, again, in whatever web browser you use. And that way, everything's updated. I know you hate long intros, and I do too. So without any further ado, let's begin the class. As I said a moment ago, the first step in this process is we need to now go into each web browser and export all of the password data into a central spreadsheet. I'm going to walk you through this process on both Safari and Chrome, and if you use something else, the process is similar. If you use Safari, I want you to go into Preferences, and at the top left, I want you to click on the Password tab. You'll now need to enter in your admin password, or some of you will be able to use your fingerprint. I now want you to click on the three dots icon here at the bottom left and select Export Passwords. I'm going to rename this document Safari Passwords just to make it a little bit easier to identify, and then I'm going to save that document to my desktop. If you're a Google Chrome user, the process is somewhat similar. Just go into Preferences and then click on Autofill, and now click on Passwords. I'm now going to click on the three dots icon right over here and then click on Export Passwords. Once again, I'm going to save this file to my desktop and make sure that the document is named Chrome Passwords. The next thing that I recommend you do is pick either one of these documents and duplicate it. Mac users, you can use Command D as in David. Windows users, it's Control D. Now let's rename this document Merged Passwords. I am now going to open the document that we did not duplicate, and I'm going to start by selecting all of the rows that contain data except the very top one. You're now going to want to copy that data to the clipboard. So Mac owners, Command C, Windows users, Control C. I'm now going to close that spreadsheet and open up the one that we just created called Merged Passwords. And the first thing that I'm going to do is go to the bottom of this document, click into the first empty cell at the bottom, and then paste the data that we just copied. Mac users, Command V, Windows users, Control V. And just like that, we have merged the data from both documents. And now that we've merged, let's purge. Now, obviously, all of the data that you're seeing on my screen is fake, but what I've done here is recreate some of the most common password issues that you may encounter. Let's start by organizing everything by website URL. So I'm going to click here at the very top of the second column and sort everything in ascending order. There's clearly a lot going on here, and I think the best place to start is by deleting any rows that correspond with dead accounts, that is, accounts that you don't use anymore. To do that, I'm now going to hold down the Command key. PC users use Control, and now I'm going to select all of the rows that contain dead accounts. Then I'm going to secondary click, PC users right click, and then select Delete Rows. The next thing I want you to look for are any cells here under usernames or passwords that are currently blank. Do you ever go to sign into a website and discover that the autofill feature does correctly fill in the password but not the username, or maybe vice versa? If that's the case, you'll probably discover a blank spot next to that website in this list. So all you have to do is add back in that username, password, or maybe email address. And later on, when we re-upload this list so that it replaces the old list, that shouldn't be an issue in the future. In the process of making this video and testing out this workflow, I have to tell you that it was significantly more difficult to try to do this using Numbers, which is made by Apple, compared to Microsoft Excel. So for those of you who happen to have both, I would absolutely recommend that you stick with Excel. Speaking of which, sponsored segment, if you ever need to buy a copy of Microsoft Office or Windows, I guarantee you that you can get it for less at softwarekeep.com. Just use promo code TECH20YT to save 20% off anything you buy, and there are no restrictions. Okay, folks, end of sponsored segment. I have a feeling you guys are gonna really love this next trick. You've probably noticed that some websites start with HTTP, whereas others use HTTPS. The difference is HTTPS uses TLS, which stands for Transport Layer Security, to encrypt normal HTTP requests and responses. So it's a good idea to use that with every website. If only there was a way to change every single website from HTTP to HTTPS. You do know where this is going, right? Mac users, Command F, PC users, Control F. This is where the Find and Replace tool is a major time saver. Let's click on the gear icon and then switch it from Find to Find and Replace. Now, all I need to do is tell it to replace every instance of HTTP colon with HTTPS colon. Going back to what I mentioned earlier, here's another example of a bug that I encountered in Numbers. You see how all of these buttons are grayed out no matter what I do? Yeah, Excel's better. Did I mention you can save 20% off any version of Office with my coupon code? Just checking. Here's another common example of something that you might encounter. You see all of these entries for Chase Bank's website, but they all have different URLs? That tends to happen on websites that allow you to log in from any page. All you have to do is delete everything you see after the .com. Let's now start to work on those reused passwords. Let's click the column that contains all of the passwords and sort it in ascending order. That way, all of the reused passwords will be grouped together. Some of you may have a column just beyond passwords called notes. I'm going to temporarily rename that column updated passwords. I'm now going to go through each cell that is next to a reused password, and I'm going to fill it with a bunch of random letters, numbers, and symbols. The next step is we can click on the URL next to these sites and navigate to the page where you can update that password. Now, all I need to do is copy and paste the new password that I just created into where it's asking me to create a new password. After you have your list perfected, we then need to make sure that we can save it as a CSV file. So from here, I'm gonna go to File, Export To, and I'll select CSV. I'm going to rename this file Updated Passwords, and just to avoid any confusion, I'm gonna delete all of the other documents from my desktop. The next step is we now need to wipe out all of the old passwords so that we can replace it with the CSV file that we just created. If you're on Safari, go back into Preferences and head over to the Passwords tab. Then press Command A on your keyboard to select all, and then select the minus symbol here at the bottom to remove them. Let's now click the three dots icon next to it, and this time we're going to select Import Passwords and point it to my new updated password file. For those of you who use Google Chrome, this process is a bit different, so let's walk through it. The first thing that we need to do is wipe out the old password data. To do that, we're going to click on where it says Chrome at the top left and select Clear Browsing Data. If we head over to the Advanced tab, let's change this first option to All Time. You will find the option to delete passwords and other sign-in data. To import the CSV file that we just created, I want you to go to passwords.google.com and then click on this little gear icon that you see at the top right. Here at the bottom of this next screen is the option to import password data from a CSV file. There is one last trick that I would like to teach you in this video, and this one is specifically for any of you out there who have lost a loved one and are now going through the process of trying to close out those accounts. Instead of trying to sort out their affairs from your own user account, what I recommend that you do is create a second user account on the same computer. That way you can keep things separate so that usernames and passwords don't cross over onto your personal side and muck up your entire keychain. I realize that many of you at home may have a lot of questions that you have formulated over the course of this video. And trust me, I get it, it's complicated stuff. I worked really hard when I was putting together this video to try to craft it into just the most important information. If you would like to book a 1-hour tech therapy session with me, please visit my website at techtalkamerica.com, and I would be happy to work with you and answer any questions that you may have. So some of you out there may have been wondering why I'm not making quite as many videos as I used to. And part of it is I have developed over the years really bad carpal tunnel, and that has come to slow me down, especially during the editing process of these videos, which is a major part of the time commitment. I'm also in a new relationship, which is really great news, and I'm starting to just get to enjoy life more. So I'm not going anywhere. I'm just releasing content a little bit more at my own pace. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to take a quick moment to hit the like button and leave me a little comment down below. If you'd like to support my YouTube channel or just say thank you or buy me a digital beer, you can send it to my Venmo account or PayPal, links down below. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.